Good afternoon. This is Kenny again here, and I'm with some thoughts from the front porch. I want to share some thoughts with you from some of the scriptures I've been reading in Philippians chapter 1, verse 12 through 18, where Paul is encouraging the church of Philippi to a response. And I want to do the same today. Also today is it's been encouraging me, and I want to encourage you with this. And I'm going to read from chapter 1, Philippians, verses 12 through 18. And it reads, "I want you to know, brothers, that what has happened to me has really served to advance the gospel, so that it has become known throughout the whole imperial guard and to all the rest that my imprisonment is for Christ. And most of the brothers have become confident in the Lord by my imprisonment, and are much more bold to speak the word without fear. Some indeed preach Christ from envy and rivalry, but others from goodwill. The latter do it out of love, knowing that I am put here for the defense of the gospel. The former proclaim Christ out of selfish ambition, not sincerely, but thinking to afflict me in my imprisonment. What then? Only that in every way, whether in pretense or in truth, Christ is proclaimed, and in that I rejoice. Yes, and I will rejoice." Here we have Paul. Paul's writing, as I've discussed before, he's writing from his place of imprisonment, a house arrest, where he's been isolated and held by the government and kept away from his community of faith. And he's writing to the Philippians, a church that knows he's in house arrest, and he's writing to them. And as I was reading this, I was thinking, like, he's writing to Philippi. Philippi is a church, the place in Macedonia that he went to, directed by God to go to, and he's there. And shortly after being there, he is arrested for preaching the gospel there in that town. And as he's arrested, he's then whipped in that time. Him and Silas, who was with him at the time, is whipped, and they're thrown and arrested and thrown into the worst part of the prison and put in stocks in that time. And so, now I'm saying this because the people of Philippi he's writing to would have known this story. Imagine the testimony that Paul being imprisoned in his first days there in Philippi. I'm sure everybody in Philippi knew of that testimony and what God did through this situation. And while he's there imprisoned, and it says at midnight, Paul and Silas were not whining or complaining. This is in Acts chapter 16, just by the way. And they weren't whining, complaining, and, you know, wishing the government would just let them loose and frustrated what was happening. No. What it says is they were praying and praising and singing hymns to God. What a response in the midst of that horrible situation. You know, nothing like what we have here. It's a lot worse. Even the imprisonment he's talking about where he's writing from is worse than what we have now. But he's writing from there, and he's in that prison in a place, and he's praising and praying with Silas. And then it says the prison was shaken, and every door that held people captive was broken loose, and they're all broken loose. And then it says the guard comes and finds what has happened, and he's ready to kill himself, and Paul says, no stop, you know, we're all still here. So I'm thinking, like, the doors are open, the prisoners could have ran. They had been hearing Silas and Paul worshiping and praising and praying, but they didn't run when they were free. Instead, they stayed. They knew something was happening. And not only that, it says that I think that they encountered God in that moment. The Spirit of God was there in that prison, in a place of isolation. You got to remember that. And he reaches to the jailkeeper, who comes and he wants to kill himself. And Paul talks to him and leads him to Christ, and he responds. And now that's the story. Philippi knows this testimony of Paul being arrested, praising and praying in the midst of it, prisoners being set free, and the prison keeper coming to Christ. And he's now writing from another place of being held captive, and he's writing to them to encourage them. He says, "I want you to know what has happened to me. What is going on right now in my life is not something I'm complaining about, not something I'm whining about. I'm not trying to get off. I'm in the midst of it, understanding that God has me here for the sake of the gospel. Not only that, I know that those that are around me, the guards, it says here, the imperial guard, or the band of guards. It was a encampment. The whole encampment of guards understood and knew that Paul was there for the cause of Christ. And Paul was, as he says, he was rejoicing, even in the midst of that, just as he did in that jail in Philippi. And here he's telling them, he's understand, God is the one that has me here. And me being here, I understand that. And I'm confident he is working in me and through me. Even so, that the people that have me under guard are the ones they recognize that Christ has me here also. Not only that, it says others now have become confident in Christ and God's in Christ and God's sovereignty in their own life, and they have become bold in speaking the gospel and sharing the good news of Jesus Christ. Some for bad reasons, some for good reasons. But in either case, Paul is just rejoicing. He says, in either way, I am just rejoicing. And in this I will rejoice. And I think back to this for us here in our current situation, whatever situation we're in. As Paul is reminding them, he's wanting to remind us that God is sovereign over all those things. And in the midst of it, God is working. We may not fully see or understand, but he was confident that God was working. And it created a confidence in others that were seeing God work through Paul. And Paul wants us to be confident in Christ's sovereign hand over our life. Confident that he's working in us. Confident he's working through us. And confident he's going to cause others to come to Christ and hear the good news in what's happening in and through our life. You know, sometimes we think that we have to understand, people are always watching us. All around us, people are watching us. They're not looking how we're going to respond in the good things that happen in our life. They're watching what's happening in the hardships of our life and how we're responding in the confidence we have in our faith in Christ that God is working in and through us. And Paul is saying, in the midst of this, Christ is being proclaimed in and through my life and others that have experienced the Christ I know. And he says, in this I rejoice. Christ is being proclaimed. And I'm going to encourage you, my brothers and sisters that are listening, is be confident that God is sovereign over your life and over the circumstances, even in the midst of maybe isolation and maybe being disconnected from people. Still, God is at work. And in that, he wants us to be confident, become bold in our sharing, not just with words, that's important, but also our life, that our life reflects the faith and the confidence we have in Christ. And in doing so, he wants us to rejoice in these moments, not be sorrowful, not be discouraged, not be depressed. I know it's hard. And there's times I can be overwhelmed by the circumstance we currently live in. But at the same time, I have to purposefully, it's been a word someone shared in our church group on Sunday, is it's a time for us to be purposeful, not just purposeful, but also intentional in responding in these moments by faith and in confidence that God is at work, and in this I will rejoice. And I pray that the joy of the Lord would be your strength, that you would find your joy in him and your confidence that he has your life. Go in peace today.